Game Awards host Jeff Keighley wears a tuxedo with sneakers, and that should tell you how seriously you should take the Game Awards. For those unfamiliar, the Game Awards is a video game awards show streamed online every December since 2014. It's essentially the successor to the Spike TV Video Game Awards. Remember the VGAs? Stop lying, no you don't. The Game Awards touts itself as the Academy Awards of Gaming, the Oscars of Gaming. In true colonizer fashion, no one actually gave them that authority, they just decided they have it. Like many people, I already did not like the Game Awards, and largely consider it a joke. But to prepare for this video, this week I watched all 7 previous Game Awards streams, over 20 hours of content.
It nearly killed me.
And by watched it, I mean I had it on in the background while playing Hades. Which, to be fair, I feel like having it on in the background while doing something else is how most people watch this thing. It was a pretty interesting experience, a glimpse into a poorly aged time capsule.
Because the category has the word performance in the title, the teleprompter is full of erection jokes. So, I'm going to skip over all that because we got to keep it classy. One of the nominees for this award is Kevin Spacey.
The fans demanded we redo Shaq Fu correctly.
And the Game Award for Developer of the Year goes to CD Projekt Red.
And the trending gamer, the Game Award goes to Boogie 2988.
Coming right up, the first ever live gameplay of Mass Effect Andromeda.
Happy to be joined by Randy Pitchford, of course you know from Gearbox, Borderlands, so many other great games. Randy.
But before we dive into lambast this thing, I'll be fair and list some of the things I like about it. I like when they have the orchestra play songs from video games, especially when they have a medley of all the Game of the Year nominees. I like the Industry Icon Award, where they honor pioneers in the gaming industry and you get to learn about their prolific careers. I like the recent Innovation in Accessibility Award, that's a good category. I like the Global Gaming Citizen segments, where you get to hear about people around the world using gaming in positive ways. I like the tribute they did for Satoru Iwata. I like the Whooper watch. Who doesn't like Whooper? Everyone likes Whooper. I like Christopher Judge's suit. He looks dope as hell. I like when Conan shows up and talks about the Game of the Year nominees. I liked how they backed up Hideo Kojima when Konami was dicking him around. And most of all, I like the rare moments when you get to hear from the people behind some of your favorite games. Which, you know, is the entire point of an award show. My problems with the Game Awards can be sorted into 2 categories: the awards process and the show itself. So, the whole thing. But let's start with
the awards process.
The Game Awards isn't the most transparent with their process, so I can only go off of what they've said in interviews, what's written on their site, and what's written on Wikipedia. They have a voting jury that submits nominees for each category. The jury is composed of different gaming media and influencer outlets from across the globe. The Game Awards only started using an international jury 2 years ago, before it was only English-speaking outlets. I mean, better late than never, but oof. Esports awards are voted on by esports people, and accessibility awards are voted on by accessibility people. Makes sense. So the jury nominates, and then whichever game gets the most nominations are the official nominees. I hope they're not using only one round of voting, but based on what they've said in interviews and the nominees each year, I'm pretty sure that's how they do it. In this type of process, especially when it involves several input sources, you'd want to use multiple rounds of voting. First round, everyone submits nominees. Second round, everyone votes on the nominations. Third round, everyone votes on the highest vote getters, and you'd continually filter down until you have your final list of nominees. Instead, what actually happens is the games that got the highest number of nominations get to be on the slate. The way they currently do it results in the biggest games of the year getting nominated for multiple awards. Each year, it's the same handful of games getting nominated for almost every award. If you have 100 people voting, and 20 of them choose, for example, The Last of Us 2, then it's gonna be on the slate even if the other 80 don't like that game. And look, I have not played The Last of Us Part 2. I don't have an opinion on The Last of Us Part 2, but I don't think that any one game is the best in the 7 different categories it won, let alone the 11 it was nominated for. Hundreds, if not thousands, of games come out every year on consoles, on mobile, on Steam, on itch, but the nominations of the Game Awards are consistently the biggest, most profitable games of that year, especially when it comes to Game of the Year, which is like the video game equivalent of Best Picture. Imagine if the nominees for Best Picture were like, alright, here's the Best Picture nominees, Avengers Endgame, Fast and Furious 10, Fast 10, your seatbelts, Avatar for some reason, Star Wars Episode 10, Fast 10, your X-Wing, and whatever the latest Pixar movie is, Ratatouille 3, Rat-Attack-Attack-Attack. And if it was like that every year, you'd be like, are these really the best movies of the year? Obviously, movies and video games aren't a one-to-one comparison, but you get what I'm saying, right? right? Best Picture nominees are often movies that not everyone has heard of, you know? Instead, they're movies that advance the medium. Like in 2020, when Parasite won Best Picture, and a lot of people hadn't heard of it, they went to go watch it and were like, hey, this is a good-ass movie. But for the Game Awards, the Game of the Year nominees are always good games, but the games that really advance the medium artistically are usually dumped into categories like Games for Impact, Best Debut Game, or Best Indie. People had noticed this and complained, so now instead in recent years, they added a sixth game that's a weird one, usually an indie game. Celeste, Control, Hades. That game hasn't ever actually won Game of the Year, but the Game Awards gets to pretend to have some added gamer clout by nominating them. And then there's awards for content creators? Well, streamers, it's always streamers. And esports athletes? You have 24 awards for the people who make video games, and then 6 awards for people who play them? Obviously, streamers and esports players are important parts of the games industry, but that would be like the Oscars having awards for, I don't know, best movie vlogger, best Letterboxd reviewer. The real reason these awards exist is so that the nominees can leverage their audience to watch the Game Awards to see if your fave won. They really deserve their own separate award show rather than being awkwardly tacked onto this one, so probably best to remove these awards. Unless I get nominated, then they can stay. And then there's fan voting for 2 categories, Most Anticipated Game and Player's Choice, where you essentially vote for the biggest snub.
Fire Emblem.
Those categories are entirely fan voted. This makes sense, they're not real awards. But then there's 10% for fan voting in the other categories. It's the illusion of choice, the illusion of influence. It's not gonna make any sort of real difference. This only exists so that companies tweet about the Game Awards to get you to vote, and so you're more likely to watch the Game Awards and see if who you voted for won. Why even have fan voting at all? 99% of fans have not played most of the games they're voting on. The most popular games get the most votes, but those popular games have already won the most important game award. Money! Also, you know how movie awards like the Academy Awards and Emmys and Golden Globes take place at the beginning of the following year, and even legitimate gaming awards take place at the beginning of the following year? Well, for the Game Awards, the nominations are determined at the beginning of November, and the show is near the beginning of December. Plenty of games come out in November and December, and technically those games are eligible for the next year's The Game Awards, but why wouldn't they just wait until the beginning of the next year to have the Game Awards? It's not like you're worried about winter weather, the show's in Los Angeles. Well, anyone who's made YouTube videos in November and December can tell you the exact reason. Money. Money. It's money. It's all about money. Money is the answer. Because the Game Awards takes place during the holiday shopping season and not afterwards, they can charge more money for ad space during the show. So get ready for more ads for Google Stadia, the thing I forget exists until I hear about it, then forget exists again 1 minute later. Which brings me to
the show.
The biggest problem with the actual The Game Awards stream is that it tries to spread itself too thin. It wants to be an award show, and it wants to be a second E3 and show a bunch of cinematic game trailers that don't actually tell you anything about the game, with new game announcements and DLC for current games, and then it wants to be a live concert, and then it wants to have movie trailers and have viral moments to get trending on social media, and then it's loaded up with a fuck ton of ads, and all of this within like 2 to 3 hours.
This is a different kind of show for me. It's going to be a little bit like E3.
Why?
When we come back, a performance by Grimes, the award for Best Action Game with Norman Reedus, and a special announcement from an Apex legend. Still to come, Ninja presents Best Multiplayer Game and an extended look at Ghost of Tsushima.
That's too many things! As a result, it has like 30 different categories, but doesn't have enough time to present all of them. So in the pre-show, they'll unceremoniously speed through several categories.
The category of Best Esports Game, presented by Grubhub, here are the nominees. And the Game Award goes to League of Legends, congratulations. For Family Game, here are the nominees. And the Game Award goes to It Takes Two.
It kind of feels like, here's the categories that no one cares about. But people do care about these categories. I will give them the benefit of the doubt and say, maybe some of those award recipients weren't able to attend the show, but I'm sure they would have done a pre-recorded message or something. And then if a game wins 2 awards, then they'll just yell it over the intercom as they're walking to the stage for a different award.
Disco Elysium also wins Best Independent Game.
I mean, on one hand, it makes sense not have the same people constantly walking up to the stage, even though you do that often for AAA games. And even though the show is streamed, it doesn't have to stick to a TV schedule, you don't want it to be too long. But when you have all this other shit in your show, but don't have time to properly present all of your awards at your award show, like, you're called the Game Awards! Shouldn't the focus be on giving out Game Awards? You have time for Pearl Jam? And Imagine Dragons, the fucking most lifeless Walmart background music of bands, but don't have time to give out all of your gaming awards at your gaming award show? Being a successor to a TV award show, it feels like they have a very TV mindset to it, in that it's not enough to only present game awards because their biggest priority is large viewership numbers, because that's what lets you charge more for ads. It's the largest font on the Rewind page of their website. It's not enough to just present awards. They've also got to do all this other shit and constantly jingle the fucking keys to keep the audience's attention. What do gamers like? E3! Game reveals! Let's spend more time on game trailers than on giving out gaming awards at our gaming award show! It really shouldn't be called the Game Awards, and instead should be called something like, I don't know, December Game Showcase featuring a couple game awards, but who gives a shit? Clearly we don't. But we also need normies to watch this. What do normies like? Celebrity cameos! Some of the presenters of the awards make sense, since they're people from the gaming industry, even if the award they're presenting has little to do with what they do in the industry. But then they also have a lot of celebrities from other industries, mostly movies, to show up and present awards. Some of it sort of makes sense, like athletes from sports presenting esports awards, actors from movies presenting the Best Acting Performance Award for video games. Keanu Reeves was literally in Cyberpunk 2077, so it makes sense for him to be there. But then some of them make no sense at all. 2020 Game of the Year was presented by Christopher Nolan, director of great movies and Tenet. He has nothing to do with video games. Why is he presenting the biggest video game award? And then there's the Industry Icon Award, which is the equivalent of like a Lifetime Achievement Award. Who should we get to present this one? Maybe a previous recipient of the award? Nope, let's get Jonah Hill, you know, from the Weed movies. What? This show has a big problem with intent versus impact. The intent of having celebrities from other industries show up is like, hey, look at all these people who like and respect this medium. Gaming is more mainstream than you may think. But the impact comes off as, we need these people to show up and give our award show some validity because we're embarrassed that it's about video games. I genuinely believe the intent of the organizers behind the Game Awards do want this to be a celebration of the gaming industry. But the impact is that it comes off as a big cash grab. And it's not much of a celebration of the gaming industry when the show has its biggest problem:
normalizing and awarding the horrible practices in the gaming industry.
Look, the AAA games industry is straight fucked. There are innumerable labor issues that will persist until game devs are able to unionize. Some examples include, but are not limited to, crunch and crunch culture, unpaid overtime, mass layoffs despite record profits, workplace harassment, racial and gender discrimination. The list goes on and on. Not to mention the predatory monetization features like loot boxes and gacha game systems to prey on gambling addictions. This stuff is rampant in the AAA games industry. Just watch any Jim Sterling video. Plus, it's well known which companies do what. However, the Game Awards ignores all these horrible practices and instead gives awards for these games. For example, crunch is a failure of leadership and directing, so a game studio that forces its employees to crunch for months to finish a product should not win the award for best game direction. But Mr. Spaceman, how do you even quantify crunch? It's all hearsay, some people may say. Well, I'm not the one giving out awards, but if I was, and if the Game Awards wants to be taken seriously instead of the joke that the industry largely regards it as, then it needs to step up and show some integrity. You need to vet your nominees. Interview devs on the projects before nominees are officially decided. Do a fucking Google search. The stuff is literally in the news. And if stuff comes out later, don't be afraid to rescind awards either. The stuff happening literally falls under the category of abuses of workers' rights. I don't think a game made with human rights abuses should be nominated for any awards. The individuals behind making games, the programmers, artists, QA, etc., aren't the ones who benefit from their game-winning awards. The company that makes their life a living hell is. So it's time to use the large platform you've built that you're so proud of to begin to hold the games industry leaders accountable. I think the intent behind the show is to be a celebration of the games industry. But to do that, you need to celebrate and support the people actually making the games. Because the impact you're having is nothing more than an executive level circle jerk that no one takes seriously. By awarding these games, you are incentivizing further labor abuses. And something that happened while writing this very video, putting out a weak statement on Twitter to get ahead of negative press about how there is no place for abuse, harassment, or predatory practices in any company, a thing that Activision Blizzard currently has multiple lawsuits against it for doing, but still keeping Activision CEO on the Game Awards advisory board isn't actually doing anything. Then the same could be said for EA, Rockstar Games, and Riot Games. Even at the 2021 Game Awards, they made an official vague statement not actually naming anyone, saying, "There's no place for workplace harassment in the games industry." Now check out a trailer for the new Star Wars game made by David Cage and Quantic Dream, who are known for workplace harassment. Oh no! This feels like a BoJack Horseman bit. And I know some
gamers
do not care about the people who make the games. They only care about the quality and expediency of the product. Don't complain about the product or its workers just consume product and get excited for next product. If devs complain about working conditions, then they aren't meant for this industry. However, the more creative and talented people who get burnt out on the industry and leave it entirely, the less good original games you're gonna get, and the more samey cookie cutter bullshit sequels and remakes and carbon copy games is gonna be. Fuck, man! Speed round of stupid Game Awards bullshit. Why the fuck was Jump Force nominated for anything? Why was Among Us nominated and won Best Multiplayer in 2020? Don't get me wrong, I love me some Amongo Bungo, but Among Us is a 2018 game. It would make sense for it to win Best Ongoing Game or something, but to win a 2020 award? I don't know, if the years don't matter, why not nominate League of Legends for Best Multiplayer every year? Or Smash Bros. Melee? Or Halo 2? How the fuck did Red Dead 2's Cowboy Twangs win Best Soundtrack over Octopath Traveler? Man, that's some bullshit. Stop super chatting during the Game Awards. What the fuck is wrong with you people? Anyways, thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe. Comment below with how you feel about the Game Awards. Also, side note, don't expect big game reveals from multi-game showcases like this or E3. You know, 15, 20 years ago, it made sense to gather the press in one area and show off your biggest games, but in today's age of social media and digital news distribution, why try to compete against other games for coverage when you can pick a random day, tweet out a trailer or announcement, and then everyone's talking about you all day long? I mean, it's cool if it still happens, just don't expect it too often.